I'm here at the World Health Organization on March 20, 2024, in the WHO negotiations on a pandemic agreement. I'm here with Mohga, and Mohga, I'd like you to introduce yourself and then explain who you represent, why you came to Geneva this week, how you think things are going, and what advice you have to the delegates.
So my name is Mohga Kamal-Yanni. I have been working in Oxfam and in developing countries as well on access to healthcare, delivery healthcare financing, and of course access to medicines. And at the moment, I am representing Oxfam here in this meeting, but I don't work for Oxfam. Just to a disclaimer. So why am I here? Because we lived through HIV. I was actually tweeting now that I have a deja vu with COVID, that we lived the same issues on HIV before. Well, after that, we had avian flu, same issues on inequality, on access to medical technologies. And it's like, you know, history loves, or actually, world leaders don't learn from history. So this pandemic accord is, I see it as a very important tool to protect everybody, not some people and some not, everybody, everywhere, no matter who they are and what the income they have, from potential pandemics and from basically health crisis. So it is really, really critical that this accord learns from the problems that we had before and avoid these problems in order to protect people. So we're advocating for practical measures, practical and commitment, not just so committing all governments to these measures that will ensure equity. So equity is not a blah blah word, and solidarity is not another blah blah word, but actually it's a commitment for the government to do to force, obligate sharing technology, sharing know-how, removing intellectual property barriers, so that there is a real sharing and a real enabling of diversified manufacturing and diversified research and development before manufacturing in developing countries, so that if we have a health crisis, then there is enough supply for everybody. We don't have to, people in developing countries don't have to wait in a queue until rich countries vaccinate or give medicine to their people, and then what's left over is it's a charity. We're not asking for a charity, we're asking for rights, for the right to health, for the right to the fruits of science, which is, these are two rights that have been signed by all countries. So all countries should protect these rights for everybody. Because also for self-interest, viruses has two characteristics. One is that they don't respect borders. And two, they mutate. That's their nature. And therefore, you know, you can't shut your borders. You can't shut and say, you know, I'll protect my people, never mind everybody else. You can't say that. So even from a domestic point of view and a very selfish point of view, you need to vaccinate and give medicines to people, or ensure that people in developing countries have medicines. Until now, the medicines that helps with COVID-19 are not available in Africa. You know, some of the doctors, when we talk to them, they haven't heard about them, because of course they're not available there and they are very expensive. So people don't have the luxury of getting these medicines, but they are in the north. And we want this treaty, this accord, this pandemic accord, to stop that inequality.
Thank you.
So my recommendation to delegates. So far, there are these points that I mentioned. There are bones of contention, including also access to pathogens and benefit sharing. So rich countries want immediate access to pathogens. So, you know, if a pathogen discover a virus or something discovered in your country in the south, you give it quickly to some labs in the north, and pharmaceutical companies quickly can make vaccines. Where is the vaccine going? It's going in the north, of course, and what's left goes to the south. And that's just not a fair or moral or ethical or even a public health good public health policy. So with all these bones of contention, it is the duty of rich countries, of delegates from the north, to make concessions. People talk about negotiation as give and take. Yeah, absolutely. Not everybody, south or north, will get everything. But let's show us what you're going to give the countries that have the resources, the technological and financial resources. What would you give and commit to give? And then you can ask developing countries to give something in return so that we can have a reasonable agreement. Thank you.